I'm Ilyan Saint-Hilaire, Microsoft employee on the Forms team, and today I want to talk about Forms embedding in HTML. Nice things about Microsoft Forms is that you can embed it inside another web page. If you have a web page for a business or a personal page, you can embed a form inside your existing web page, and that can be very useful for a whole bunch of stuff. So in this video, I want to demonstrate how form embedding inside HTML works and just give you a little example. I'm going to start by going, of course, on my desktop here, and I'm going to have two things here. First of all, I already have a sample web page, and I'm going to open it. And in this case, I'm going to open it with Visual Studio, but you can use any text editor that you want for that. And so, and I'm going to be editing my page in raw source code. So right here, I have my sample HTML. It doesn't do very much at all. In fact, it does nothing at all. And I'm going to open the page with the browser, and you can see it's completely blank. So I'm going to write that this is a sample web page right here, and I'm going to have a paragraph. I'm going to close the paragraph. There it goes. And I am going to be done. And I'm going to refresh, and you're going to see here it says simple web page. Now I can put a title, simple title, and so on and so forth. So when I refresh here, it says simple title on the top. Okay, so I have my sample web page now. Obviously, this would be something a little more complicated. I want to embed a form. For example, I want to get feedback from my customers about the various things, or I want to use it as a registration form for an event I'm organizing, and so on. So I'm going to go over to forms.microsoft.com. And I'm going to log in here and just create a new sample form. So I'm going to create a new form that just says feedback. And I'm going to have, for example, a rating. And it's going to be a 5-star rating. There it goes. And I'm going to put require. And in the settings, I'm going to say accept responses. I won't allow them to save. And normally I would put hide submit for another response right here. But that's it. And then what is our rating? For example, rating. There it goes. And then you have stars here, and you can pick the levels and so on. Okay, perfect. So I have my little form. Obviously, it can be more complicated than this, but this will do for now. And then I want to go and I can preview it. This is what it looks like. Good. And then what I'm going to do is collect responses. And there's different options, of course, for how you want to use this form to collect responses. But one of them is called embed right here, and it gives you HTML code. So you can copy this, you know, by selecting it, or you can hit the copy button, and it will copy it in your clipboard. Okay, so now that I have this form here in my clipboard, I am going to go back to my sample webpage, and I am going to go to the source code, and inside the body element, I'm going to paste this iframe HTML. And then I'm going to hit refresh, and you will see that the feedback form is now embedded inside my own web page. There's a couple of things here that you'll notice. By default, it's an iframe, of course. This is the iframe that the form is embedded in. And it has a width of 640 and a height of 480. You can, of course, adjust that if you want to make it a little less tall. And then there's things like the frame border. And there's something called allow full screen. This is likely for mobile devices. And that's it. Okay. So we are good to go. We have the form right here. Now, another thing I want to do just for fun is I would like to make it so that this only shows up when somebody press a button to ask for feedback. So just, this is really simple code here, but I'm going to put ID equals my form right there. And then I'm going to create a button. So input, let's see here, type button value show feedback. Perfect. And then I'm going to have some scripts. I'm going to have a function that show my form. And this is going to be, let's see, it is document.get. Element by ID. This is like very classic thing you do, my form. And then you say style display equals null. And I'm gonna add some new style here. And I'm gonna say display none. Okay, so what this display none is going to do is hide this form, and the name of my form is now my form, and that's it. So now when I refresh, it's just going to hide the entire form, but it's going to show this feedback button, and then I'm going to say onClick, run the show my form function. And this will run, and that will set the style display to null. And by setting it to null, it will basically remove this display none and make the form display. So if that's saved, I'm going to hit refresh. And then when I click show feedback, you can see the form show up here. I can also put a paragraph right after the button just to make it look a little better. Show feedback, and then you see the form show up. And then I can select the rating I want, 5-star, click submit, and boom, I've submitted my feedback right here. So that is, in a nutshell, how you embed a Microsoft form inside another web page. This can be useful for lots and lots of things. You want to have people register for an event that you have. You want to collect feedback. You want to just collect any information. And the other nice thing about this, if you think about it a little bit, if you have a web page that has some static code on it and you want to collect data, normally you would have to collect the data inside your own database in the back end and so on. So that's a lot of work. By embedding a form here, you're saving yourself a lot of work. If it's something that Microsoft Form can do, of course, but instead of having all this backend database and structuring the form and collecting all the data and then sorting up the responses, one of the nice things you can do is basically you have a static web page that's hosted on some provider that's very simple and cheap to do, and then use Microsoft Form as the data collection for your data. Anyway, hopefully that was useful. Thank you very much and have a great day.